Hello, everybody. Reverend Dr. Red here. Now, this video is going to be briefing on Islam and the Bible. I want everybody to understand that I'm not attacking Islam, the followers. I'm not attacking the Muslims, per se. Okay? Let's make that really clear now. I'm going to do a series of videos speaking on Islam, not necessarily following this video immediately after, but I'm going to have quite a few videos covering Islam. If you go to spiritualmessiahministries.org, I already have quite a few articles and a couple of podcasts that can be found there covering the topic of Islam and what Islam really is, and covering the threat that Islam is, not just to the Jews and Christians, but to Western society and to mankind as a whole. And before anybody starts attacking me with any hate comments, I want to understand now that I'm here to preach the truth. I'm here to correct all the fallacies in all of the world faiths. So don't think it's because it's very clear that I follow Christianity and you know I follow Jesus Christ. Don't think that I'm going to leave mainstream Christianity alone. Okay? I'm going to have videos on Catholicism, on the truth of Catholicism, the true history that the Vatican doesn't want anybody to know. And I'm also going to be attacking, or should I bring to light, different truths about different of the Protestant denominations. So this isn't an attack strictly on Islam. It's not an attack on the followers of Islam, per se. I mean, after all, you can only believe what you're led to believe. My job here is to bring to light the wrongs, the fallacies, and the belief systems, to bring everybody to walk down the path of light. Any Muslim that watches my videos, reads my articles, or listens to my podcasts, or any other publications that appear on spiritualmessiahministries.org, it is now up to them to look at the facts for what they are, and they either now walk down the path of light, or they continue in the ways of darkness. Only after hearing the truth, and you still continue walking down the wrong path, only then is it your fault, and only then will I blame you personally. As of right now, who I'm blaming for all the fallacies and all world faiths is the spiritual leaders that have led the people down the wrong path. And then back to the point of this video. This video is going to be on Islam and the Bible. Now, if you argue with or debate with any Muslim, they're going to say that Islam is mentioned all throughout the Bible. I know this to be true only because I have debated with numerous Muslims on this very topic from all countries, whether they were born and raised here in America, Christian born and converted to Islam, or Hindi-born, converted to Islam, born and raised in an Islam nation in the Middle East. I've debated with them all. I've spoke with quite a few Muslim converts, as well as ex-Muslims that converted outside of Islam, quite a few that had converted from Islam to Christianity. One of these particular debates took place on Twitter. I was posting a couple of facts about Islam with the links to the articles where I had found the information I was talking about. And a Muslim, I believe he was from India, we spent quite a few weeks debating between, you know, what I had to say and the information that I had found, and he was trying to use the Quran to debate with me. which is only typical. I mean, if somebody tries debating with a Christian about Christianity, are you not going to go back at them with what Scripture says in the Bible? Unfortunately for him, I knew too much about the Quran and the fact that it is not written in order. There are certain verses that are put in later on that now make prior verses null and void. So a lot of the verses that he was using to justify the peace and love that Islam preaches to the world today, I was able to show him that I know he's just trying to debunk what I'm saying and to convert me to Islam using lies and deception. But then again, the Quran does say that they can lie and deceive to take out the enemy or to bring more followers to Allah. There are numerous verses in the Quran that specifically name Christians and Jews as the enemy. In one verse, it specifically says that to leave the Christians alone because Christians are learned people, we just went astray. So I'll give them back. And then in the later verse, that now makes that verse null and void, it states that Christians, along with the Jews, must die. We are to be killed. We're infidels. Anybody who's not a Muslim is considered an infidel. The most dangerous infidel to Islam is the Jews and the Christians. This is because Judaism and Christianity are two of the religions of light. They fear that Judaism and Christianity will, if left alone, will eventually show the light into the darkness of Islam, show Allah to be Satan, and Islam, as they know it, will perish. Now, the reason why I'm saying that Allah is Satan is because he is. There's quite a few examples in the Quran and in the Bible that suggest that. If you look at Bible prophecy in Revelations and you compare that to the prophecy in the Quran, it is very similar in some respects, but it's complete opposites. I'm going to get to that in a moment. I have written here certainly a few examples on that. If you go to spiritualmessiahministries.org, this is from the basic information I'm covering in this video here is covered in depth in two articles on spiritualmessiahministries.org. The one article is literally called Islam and the Bible. Islam and the Bible, in that article, it breaks down what the public is shown, at least here in America, what the public is shown Islam to be, and all the lies that surround Islam. And it also goes into a few examples of the Quran as opposed to the Bible head on head. And my camera seems to be slipping here. Side by side, it shows the Quran against the Bible. It is a somewhat lengthy article, but again, all the information is there. It attacks numerous false ideologies that's put forth and propagandized in quite a number of nations around the world to promote Islam. Unfortunately, the more Islam is promoted, naturally, the more people will convert to Islam, the more rights Islam will get on the political spectrum. Muslims will now start taking over political offices, and before you know it, you are now being ran under Sharia law. If you want an example of this, you can look at Europe and just the fact that they have no goal zones, where if you're not a Muslim, you're not allowed in that area, including the police of the respective nations in Europe. And these areas are completely under Sharia law. Here in America, there's over 30 encampments where there's no go zones if you're not a Muslim, and they are governed under Sharia law, not constitutional law. Let's see what I got here. And I'm just going to read a few examples of Bible to the Quran, just so you can see a few of the differences. And like I say, you're going to hear arguments from Muslims. I'm probably going to get quite a few comments calling me a fundamentalist or a radical or a racist. Unfortunately, you can't use the term racist because of the fact, well, Muslim isn't a race. Just like Christianity, it's not a race. It's a faith. Just like you have your white Christians, your black Christians, your Asian Christians, your Hispanic Christians. Same with Muslims. You have your white Muslims, your black Muslims, your Asian Muslims, your Arab Muslims. Not all Arabs are Muslim. Not all Muslims are Arab. Let's get that squared away right off the bat. My purpose through this video is, again, just to touch base. I just want to give you a few examples of how Islam compares to the Bible. I'm going to refer you again to the articles on the website. It's more in depth there. And there will be future videos where I go more in depth in Islam. Right now, I just want to get a couple of points out to everybody, a couple of facts out there. There's a couple of hard points, so if you ever should get into an argument with a Muslim, you have a good idea of what's really going on there. Now, in the Bible, it states, this is information I'm pulling from the article, is the Antichrist a Muslim? It's on spiritualmuslimministries.org. The first part of that, the first third of that article is written by myself. The second third of that article was written by another person. And the third part of the article is written by another. And I do have their names and their websites up there in case you want to go to their website or contact them for further information from their angle. Come on. And again, you can contact me personally. My email is on the website, as well as the email to the minister on that website. So you can contact me personally to discuss the matter with me if you feel I have any facts wrong. But I can assure you that none of my facts are wrong. Considering I am trying to preach the truth, my ministry is behind the Spiritual Truth Movement and Coalition. I'm not going to get in front of this camera or in front of the microphone to record my podcasts, or on the keyboard to write an article, and not to know all the facts. I'm not going to utter anything that I feel could be proven wrong. I'm going to make sure that I understand all the facts before I say anything. And it's really important the information gets out there. Now, in the Bible, I state the Antichrist is an unparalleled political, military, and religious leader that will emerge in the last days, okay? In Islam, the Mahdi is an unparalleled political, military, and religious leader that will emerge in the last days. Now, the Mahdi is their 12th imam, so to speak, It's their prophet, their savior, or however you want to look at that. In the Bible, the false prophet is a secondary prominent figure that will emerge in the last days who will support the Antichrist. Okay? Now, in Islam, the Muslim Jesus, okay, not the real Jesus Christ, the Muslim Jesus, is a secondary prominent figure that will emerge in the last days to support the Mahdi. In the Bible, the Antichrist and the false prophet together will have a powerful army that will do great damage to the earth in an effort to subdue every nation and dominate the world. In Islam, the Mahdi and the Muslim Jesus will have a powerful army that will attempt to control every nation of the earth and dominate the world. In the Bible, the false prophet is described essentially as a dragon in lamb's clothing. In Islam, the Muslim Jesus comes bearing the name of the one that the world knows as the Lamb of God, Jesus Christ. Yet the Muslim Jesus comes to murder all those who do not submit to Islam. In the Bible, the Antichrist and the false prophet establish a new world order. In Islam, the Mahdi and the Muslim Jesus establish a new world order. In the Bible, the Antichrist and the false prophet institute new laws for the whole earth. In Islam, the Mahdi and the Muslim Jesus institute Islamic law all over the earth. In the Bible, the Antichrist is set to change the times. In Islam, it is quite certain that if the Mahdi established Islam all over the earth, he would discontinue the use of Saturday and Sunday as the weekend for days of rest, but rather Friday, the holy day of Islam. Also, he would most certainly eliminate the Gregorian calendar and replace it with the Islamic calendar used in every Islamic country. Are you starting to see where this is all heading at? I'll continue. In the Bible, the Antichrist and the false prophet will both be powerful religious leaders who will attempt to institute a universal world religion. In Islam, the Mahdi and the Muslim Jesus will institute Islam as the only religion on the earth. In the Bible, the Antichrist and the false prophet will execute anyone who does not submit to their world religion. In Islam, likewise, the Mahdi and the Muslim Jesus will execute anyone who does not submit to Islam. In the Bible, the Antichrist and the false prophet will specifically use beheading as the primary means of execution for nonconformists. In Islam, the Mahdi and the Muslim Jesus will use Islamic practice of beheading for executions. In the Bible, the Antichrist and the false prophet can have a specific agenda to kill as many Jews and Christians as possible. In Islam, the Mahdi and the Muslim Jesus will kill as many Jews as possible until only a few are left hiding behind rocks and trees. In the Bible, the Antichrist and the false prophet can attack the conqueror and seize Jerusalem, the Battle of Armageddon. In Islam, the Mahdi and the Muslim Jesus will attack the reconquer and seize Jerusalem for Islam. In the Bible, the Antichrist will set himself up in the Jewish temple as the seat of authority, the abomination of desolation. In Islam, the Mahdi will establish the Islamic Caliphate from Jerusalem. In the Bible, the false prophet is set to do many miracles to deceive as many possible for supporting the Antichrist. In Islam, the Mahdi himself is set to control the weather and the crops. His face is set to glow. We can also assume that since Jesus is viewed as having been empowered by Allah to work miracles when he was here on earth the first time, he will most likely be expected to continue to do so when he returns. The Bible, the belief at the time of Muhammad, and still believed by some people today, was that the Antichrist can be described as riding on a white horse in the book of Revelation. In Islam, the Mahdi is described as riding on a white horse, ironically in the same verse in Revelation. In the Bible, the Antichrist is said to make a peace treaty with many, with Israel for 7 years. In Islam, the Mahdi is to make a peace treaty through a Jew, specifically a Levite, for exactly 7 years. In the Bible, Jesus, the Jewish Messiah, can return to defend the Jews in Israel from a military attack from a coalition of nations led by the Antichrist and the false prophet. In Islam, the Dajjal, if I'm pronouncing that correctly, the Islamic Antichrist, will gain a great Jewish following and claim to be Jesus Christ and fight against the Mahdi and the Muslim Jesus. Do you see what just happened there? They're going to perceive the real Jesus as their false Jesus. In the Bible, the Antichrist specifically denies the most unique and central doctrines of Christianity, namely the divinity of Jesus, the incarnation of God in the flesh, and the substitutionary death of Jesus on the cross. In Islam, doctrinally and spiritually specifically denies the most unique and central doctrines of Christianity, namely the divinity of Jesus, the incarnation of God in the flesh, and the substitutionary death of Jesus on the cross. In the Bible, the primary warning of Jesus and the Apostle Paul was to warn Christians of the abundance of deceit and deception in the last days. Now, in Islam, is perhaps the only religion on earth that practices deceit as one of its tools to assist its own ascendancy. It actually has a specific doctrine which allows and even calls for deception to be used to achieve its desired end. In the Bible, from the Bible and history, we learn that the final Antichrist Empire will be a revived version of the empire that succeeded the Roman Empire. In Islam, the empire that succeeded the Roman and Byzantine Empire was the combined Holy Roman Empire in parallel with the Islamic Ottoman Empire. Bible. When the Antichrist emerges, a system will already exist, poised to receive him as a savior and to give allegiance to him. In Islam, is already the second largest religion and will at present growth rates become the largest religion within a few decades. Islam awaits the coming of the Mahdi with universal anticipation. The Catholic Church and many Christian churches believe that the Muslims will be saved just like Christianity will be, and believe that they worship the same God as Christianity. It's a very short step to convert to Islam, if that is believed to be the truth. So my camera keeps on slipping here. So, now that's a few examples of strictly prophecy, revelations in the Christian Bible, as opposed to that of the Quran. Camera doesn't want to say stuff for me. So as you can see, we are dealing with a very dangerous mindset. the scriptures to that prove those the facts that I just read out to you can be found in the articles. The one article is called "Is the Antichrist a Muslim?" The other article is called "Islam and the Bible." And both of those articles can be found at spiritualmessiahministries.org. And as I said before, Islam and the Bible article is a three-part article. Can we go on the same page? The top section is my words, followed by the scripture that proves my point. And then you have another article below mine. It's on the Bible article. So read that, it's on the Bible, and read, "Is the Antichrist a Muslim?" It's on spiritualmessiahministries.org. Both of those articles go in way more depth than what I just covered here in this video. Again, the purpose of this video is just to get some of the basic facts out to you, just to kind of set the stage for my future videos that I'm going to be recording on Islam. And hopefully it raised a few questions in all of your minds, to now you're questioning, well, is that really what it says? I mean, that shows pretty strongly that, you know, the Antichrist of the Christian Bible is the savior of the Quran. What's wrong with that picture? Well, to get that answer question, that question answered, go to spiritualmessiahministries.org and read the articles, Islam and the Bible, and "Is the Antichrist a Muslim?" And both of those articles go in great depth about where exactly in the Bible Islam is spoken about. It compares the Quran and the Bible side by side. It brings to light a lot of information about Islam. And there's a whole bunch of truths there. And like I said, a lot of you people that are secular in nature, whether you want to call yourself a Christian, you want to call yourself a Muslim, you want to call yourself a Hindu, a Buddhist, a Zoroastrian, whatever. If you're secular in nature, a lot of the facts set forth in this video and in those two articles are probably going to be hard for you to believe. However, unfortunately, it is fact. A lot of people put a lot of time and effort into these studies. And unfortunately, history, as well as current events, as well as scriptures from numerous different faiths, all back up the information that Islam is a very, very dangerous threat. Now, they say that Muslims will say that Islam is the true religion. They'll try telling you that it compares to Christianity and Judaism and the fact that they use all of our prophets. Okay, fine. You open up the Quran, start reading through the Quran. If you have no idea what you're reading, so right off the bat, you're not going to be aware of the fact that a lot of the verses that seemingly promote peace and they seemingly promote, you know, love towards the Jews and the Christians are later on in the Quran, in later on added verses, now deem those other verses null and void. Unlike the Bible, where you can track history with the Bible, you can't do that in the Quran. They did that in such a manner as to, for the purpose of deceiving non-Muslims. to convert them to Islam. And once you're a Muslim, it's now against Sharia law, which is the law you have got to follow as a Muslim. It is against Islamic law to convert outside of Islam. So once you convert to Islam, that's it. You're done. And now they're going to start teaching you the true ways of Islam and what verses are null and void and what verses you can still go by. So, anyways, you're reading through the Quran and you're talking with the Muslim is pointing out all these verses to you. Well, Reverend Dr. Red's wrong, and he's false, because look, it says here that, you know, we're to respect the Christians, and the Christians are very nice, warm people, and blah, 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 blah. What they don't tell you, however, is this verse over here now makes this verse over here null and void. You have to kill the Christians and the Jews. You have to kill all the non-Muslims. So says Allah. They don't tell you that. And the Quran was written in such a manner that unless you know how to read a Quran correctly, you're going to miss all those points. I got to stop this damn camera from sliding. You're gonna miss all those points. In Islam, it's mainly the imams that have the correct format of how to read the Quran, and they're not going to teach you the correct way. And they want you to view Islam as it's a religion of peace, it's a religion of love, it's the right path. You know, it's a real ethical way of living. They're not. They don't want you to view it any other way than that. Once you convert to Islam, then you're going to get all that other information that they left out. I've spoken to numerous Muslims, to numerous ex-Muslims that converted to Christianity from Islam, that moved to America from Pakistan and Afghanistan. And a few Muslims came to America to work. They had their families all still over there. They came here to work. I believe they were from Bahrain. And they spoke with me about Islam. So it's not like I'm feeding you information that has no backing. It has much backing to it. I spoke firsthand to these people. Okay. I've also did rather extensive studies. I've also read other people's studies. You know, this isn't just, you know, some conspiracy theory that I've come up with, or a conspiracy theory that I found on the internet that I'm backing. It's all factual. I just gave you a couple of examples comparing the Quran revelation to the Bible revelations of Christianity. Again, the scriptures that backed it up are in the articles on the website. As a matter of fact, let me see if I have, if I can pull anything else up just to go over real quick with you. A point I was originally trying to make here before I went off on my little tangent. If you talk with a Muslim, they're going to try to say that they're the right path and all this other nonsense. That's what it is, nonsense. And they're going to try saying that you go by our prophets and they believe in Jesus Christ too and all sort of nonsense and that they're children of Abraham. Well, it might be children of Abraham. Now, let me ask you this question. Abraham had two sons, one from his wife, one from the servant woman. The story of Cain and Abel. Sorry, I'm mixing up story. I'm getting... This is what happens when I get my... See, I can't talk. This is what happens when I get all flabbergasted. My mind starts running and I start mixing stories up, which is probably why I should organize my thoughts before I start talking about it. But now that I brought that up, let me ask you this. Look at Cain and Abel. Two brothers, right? The one killed each other. Killed the other one. Now, you tell me which son do you believe gave the offspring to the Jews, the Israelites, and which son do you believe gave offspring to the Muslims? Granted that Muslims do feel that our God is Allah, they try and justify it by saying they too believe in Jesus Christ and in all of our prophets. They want to trace back down the history. That's fine and great. But I'm going to say that they are not our brothers. Islam is not a brother faith or a sister religion of Christianity and Judaism. You might want to call them cousins, but that's about as far as it goes. They do not come from the same bloodline that the Christians and the Jews do. And they came, they're spawns of Satan, plain and simple. Islam is satanic religion, plain and simple. I know I'm trying to keep this video to a certain point, but my mind starts going off and I can't keep my, I can't. It's hard for me to stay focused on just one thing when I'm talking about everything, all the information is important to get out there, and it just flows. And like you just saw happen, you know, I'll try to relate it to one story in the Bible. It flows into another story, which also then flows into historical events, which I can very easily compare to current events. So, and I promise future videos of doing Islam, I'll try to have an outline of when I'm going to speak about it so I can try to keep myself on a better train of thought. And hopefully I can stop screwing myself up. I seem to be really good at that, trying to keep on one key point and I go off. Now, I'm just looking to see if I can find anything that I can mention here real quickly to you about Islam and the Bible, other than what I already told you. I mean, it's so easy for me to go off topic of keeping it strictly with the Bible, Islam, how it compares to the Bible, because there's all this information is just so important. And I really don't want to read the whole article because that would take I'd rather speak to you, hold a conversation with you rather than sit here and read a story to you, like I said, all this information is really important for me to get out to you because it is all important. It really saddens me as a Christian to know that worldwide, including here in America, Everybody's in this shit telling me that no, it's not happening. Well, I'm going to tell you, open your eyes. It is happening. Go to my Facebook page. Go to the website. You know, there's articles at the Yin Yang. Google it. There's articles all over the place of different persecutions happening in America. But it really saddens me to think that so many Jews and Christians globally are being persecuted against. Not just by the governments and by other people in particular, but specifically by Muslims, by the political system and the faith of Islam. And you have so many westernized Christians who clearly have no clue what it means to be a Christian, that, you know, because of their cluelessness as to what Christianity really is and to who Jesus Christ really is, are either believing this nonsense that Islam is a religion of peace, or they're going all the way out as far as converting to Islam, only to later on realize what a mistake it was. Right down to the fact that, you know, I've seen Islamic women that were born and raised American Christians, whether they would be Protestant in the Bible Belt or Catholic, that convert to Islam. They wear the whole getup, the burqa and all, and they call themselves liberated women. They're now saved. They found their way. You're not allowed to show yourself. You have to cover your whole body. You're not allowed to talk to anybody. Your whole family, if they stay Christian, they don't convert to Islam with you. You're no longer allowed to associate with your family. That's being liberated? Are you people completely insane? You want to be liberated, Christianity, Judaism. That's liberation. That's freedom. Not Islam. There's so much important information here. I'm going off on other topics that are associated around Islam. And it's also very important. I'm going to have future videos on this topic. I'm going to have future videos on Islam. I'm not going to worry about titling them in the beginning of the video until after I do the video, and then I'll worry about titling them to put them up on the YouTube channel. There's just so much more information out there, and clearly as this video just went, I'm trying to stay strictly on Islam and the Bible, and it's getting me off on all these other topics revolving around Islam, and the threat it holds to Christianity and to Jews. Just a quick recap. Like I said, when I pointed out to you, going by the Quran revelations and the Bible revelations, I just showed you that the Quran, Islam, is the complete opposite of Christianity and Judaism. The complete opposite. Now, if Islam is the complete opposite of Christianity and Judaism, what does that make Allah? It makes Allah Satan. If Christianity and Judaism is about peace, then that makes Islam about destruction. If Christianity is about truth, then that means that Islam is about lies and deception. As a matter of fact, look at the Quran. In the Quran, they tell you it is okay to lie and to deceive non-believers to bring them to Allah. If that doesn't work, kill them. They're infidels. Kill them. Now, I did have one other sensitive information I wanted to get out on this video pertaining to Islam and the Bible. Unfortunately, I'm having a hard time finding it in my phone. And I found it, but there was key points I wanted to make, aside from the one that I already did. And my mind is just going. And this video seems to be going. Where we're at, 45 minutes so far. Alright. I don't want to keep anybody here for hours on end. I'm going to stop my rant. I think only as well 45 minutes, 46 minutes. I think I only managed to do, what, 15 approximately minutes? Staying on the topic I want to cover. Yeah, I'm doing really good these days. Now, I showed you a brief example of Islam's true nature, of Allah's true identity, and what Islam thinks of Jesus Christ. One that did the deity out of Jesus Christ. And two, their Jesus is equivalent to our false prophet. I'm going to close this video out now. I'm losing my whole train of thought here. I really wanted to do this video on strictly Islam in the Bible, showing you how it compares. And I went off topic. I might do an Islam in the Bible 2. Hopefully, staying on topic, but I'm going to have more videos on Islam that that you can stay rest assured on. In the meantime, please go to spiritualmessiahministries.org, read Is the Antichrist the Muslim, read Islam and the Bible. Listen to the podcast that it's linked in one of those articles. There's a few other articles linked in those articles. Click on the links. Google it. Fill yourself up full of information. We're at war here, people. The Muslims are going to try to convert Christians and Jews and everybody else to Islam by comparing the Quran to the Bible, showing how similar it is. Don't fall for it. Using their book of Revelations, comparing it to the book of Revelations in the Bible, I just showed you how Allah is Satan, their Jesus is our false prophet, they are lying to you, they are deceiving you. Don't fall for their nonsense. It's a bunch of nonsense. It's blasphemy. Don't fall for it. It says right in the Bible, we are going to be deceived. There, in end times, we're going to be deceived. There's going to be mass delusions put over everybody. Right now, I'm watching that happen. I'm watching that happen. There are hundreds of thousands of millions of people, not just here in America, but over in Europe and globally, falling for this charade that Islam is a religion of peace. Falling for the charade that they're the way. Hundreds of thousands of Christians and Jews are converting to Islam every day in America and England alone. I'm telling people, don't fall for it. Do your research. Like I pointed out in the beginning of this video, Allah is Satan. Satan is Allah. By converting to Islam, you might manage to keep yourself alive for a few more days. But when they're done using you, they're going to kill you too. It's right there in the Bible. Don't fall for it. Please, do me a favor. Do yourself a favor. Do Jesus Christ a favor. Open your eyes. Open your ears. Pay attention to what's going on around you. Pay attention to how people are speaking to you. How they're speaking. When a Muslim begins conversing with you, especially if you're a Christian or a Jew, please point out the facts to them. Help them understand. Now I'm going to tell you this. That Muslim that I told you I was conversing with on Twitter, he tried using the King James Version Bible to prove me wrong. And him right. Trying to get me to convert to Islam. Now, I've been preaching for 3 years now. I became a legally ordained minister back in January. I had just received my doctor's divinity degree back in December of 2010. I studied 32 faiths. I spent 11 years in this study. My ministry went public in April, brand new ministry. And he felt he could convert me and tell me what I know to be true is wrong. After the extensive amount of studies that I just did, the achievements that I've accomplished through my studies, and the fact that my studies are continuing every day, he felt he can tell me that I'm wrong. And he started using verses from the very Bible translation that I use and tell me that I'm wrong. Now, I combated him by comparing that verse in the Bible that he was trying to use against me to the verse in the Quran that he was trying to similarize it with. And I was showing him he is the one that is wrong. I don't know what I'm talking about. He can't fool me. I'm a warrior of Christ. His spirit is flowing through my blood. He has taken home in my heart. The Muslims can't fool me. Allah will not have my soul. He wound up speaking in circles, okay? He was literally speaking in circles. He ran out of information he can say to me. He then goes to his imam, tells him about the conversation, and comes back at him with information his imam had told him. And I came back at him with even more information, proving his imam wrong. His imam, that's their priest or pastor. Their spiritual leader. Now, all he was able to do now is keep on referring me to the same website, to the same article that I've already time and time again proved to him was wrong. And it's him talking to me in circles again. And so he finally tries harassing me. But you see, that's what they do. They'll keep on speaking in circles because they don't have answers. They know they're wrong. They know they're lying to you. And they want to kill the Christians and the Jews because they know that we can shed light into their darkness. They know that there are Muslims, born and raised Muslim, and that upon hearing the gospel, see the light, and they leave Islam, knowing that they leave Islam, they are putting themselves at risk of murder, of execution. And they will still leave Islam to convert to Christianity. Because they see the light, they've come to the light. And that is why they want to kill us off. You kill all the Jews and you kill all the Christians, there's nobody left in the world to preach the gospel. Nobody's preaching the gospel, nobody's preaching the word of God. Then nobody's going to be able to leave Satan to follow God. So please, arm yourselves with the truth. They feel, which has been proven throughout history, because they keep on repeating the same information to you, the same thing over and over and over and over again, eventually you will believe it. Don't fall for their lies. Learn the truth. Armor yourself with the truth. The truth will prevail. The truth will set you free. Jesus' own words. So again, please, go to spiritualmessiahministries.org, read Is the Antichrist a Muslim, and read Islam and the Bible. Google the topic. Click on the links in the articles. Listen to the podcast. Feel free to email me. Subscribe to my channel. There will be further videos on this topic. Hopefully I can stay on one specific topic at a time per video in my future videos. I really didn't mean for this video to be jumping all over the place. Like I said, it's all important information. It all needs to get out there. And it's trying to use the Bible against you. Don't let it happen. No matter what happens, stay true to Jesus. Allow Jesus to take home in your heart. When you are conversing with a Muslim, don't worry about what you do or don't know. Give yourself up to Jesus. He will speak through you. Okay? Don't worry about what to say. But it is important to have as much information on the matter as you possibly can. One way of doing this is to watch my future videos, can go to the website, read the articles, and listen to the podcast. Click on the links that I give you. Google it. I'm sure people have written more updated articles with more in-depth information that I have available on my website. So before I keep on sound like a broken record here and sound redundant, I'm going to have future videos. Subscribe to my channel. There will be future videos on Islam. I'm probably going to be doing another one on Islam and the Bible, hopefully where I can keep it more strictly on subject matter of comparing the Quran and the Bible. Go to spiritualmessiahministries.org. Islam and the Bible. Is the Antichrist a Muslim? Read those articles, click on the links to the other articles, listen to the podcast, do your homework, do your research. Do not allow yourself to be fooled. Email me if you would like to chat on this subject matter, or if you have further information on the subject matter of, pertaining to the Quran and the Bible, and you can like to be a guest on one of our podcasts or on one of my videos, you can shoot me an email and we'll see if we can work it out. I compared to you the Book of Revelations in the Bible and Quran. That's one book. One book I compared to you in this video. And you can see that Islam, yes, is spoken about in the Bible. As Satan. Islam is the beast. Now just imagine when I do Islam in the Bible 2. In that video, if I go into the Quran and the Bible as a whole, or if I pick another book from the Quran, another section from the Quran, another book or section of the Bible, what information will be there? Stay tuned. In the meantime, read those articles, get informed, don't allow yourself to fall for the lies, don't allow yourself to be deceived. We are the last hope. Share this video, copy it, mirror it, wherever the link over is on YouTube. Link to it, embed it. Subscribe to my future videos. Spread the past videos, spread my future videos. This information has to get out there. In the future videos, I will try to be more flowing in what I'm saying. So I'm not going all over the place like I did in this video. Be safe. Until next time, God bless.